just magical, magnificent. I've never seen so many colors, so many things with colorful feathers, so many slithering, crawly, beautiful things that I could never imagine. I've tasted so many different kinds of fruit or ice cream made from that strange fruit as well. It was incredible. I know a lot of people on the planet believe in reincarnation, but I'm not sure if I believe in such a literal form, and if I did, then I think this would be my first time, because I'm just absolutely amazed and taken by the wonders of this world, by the creatures that can be transparent and float and fly and polka dotted and striped, and that you can drop something you can barely even see into the ground, and the tree comes up with feet and fruit, and water that we need to drink literally pours out of the ground in its pristine fresh form. And all these things are absolute miracles to me that I'm absolutely just floored by the magic and beauty of. And so I guess that's why I'm so invested in the concept of global sustainability. Sustainability isn't my favorite word. I really like not things to stay the same. I like things to thrive. But I do believe that the best and most powerful thing that any of us can do to create a world where we all can thrive and every other thing can thrive is to start with yourself. And so I really love that concept. I'm a relatively introverted person, probably shaking my hands, but I don't like talking in front of people. But so I always thought that the best personal action that I could take was to just live in harmony with my beliefs as much as possible. And it's something that I've been trying to do, and that I constantly try to do, because it's an eternal evolution. You know, the more you learn, the more you have to adapt and adjust and try to simplify and get down to the essence of things. And so I got myself, for the most part, off of petroleum in terms of my vehicles, but even that can be done wrong if it's not done in the right way. And so I've been learning about that process. I've got myself off of the grid, which means that I use my energy from the sun instead of energy from giant centralized programs and things like that. And I still think that taking personal responsibility is the first and most important, most potent step that any of us can take. Because if we all really took personal responsibility, we wouldn't be in quite the mess that we're in. But we don't really have a choice unless you're informed. And part of the personal responsibility is getting educated and getting informed and then sharing that information. And that's what's so exciting. And I guess on the positive side of this conversation, because the more you learn, the more you realize that we have solutions to all the crises we face. We are just overwhelmed right now by a crisis. You know, we've got more slaves now than any other time in human history. We have the oceans acidifying, the forests are, the lungs of our planet are getting deforested. There's overpopulation crisis. There's an environmental crisis. There's economic crisis. There's crisis on every level. But when you start learning, you realize that there are solutions to every single one of these issues, and that is good news, and that gives you reason for hope and a reason for optimism, and really is the thing that excites me about this whole approach to life, is really focusing on solutions and focusing on the positive and getting that information out there, because so many people think that we